We go. There's a half hour remaining. We're in 216th place. Let's try to get first. 23 and a half hours late.
Red Eye Zack.
Sorry about the
Red Eye
noise.
Zack.
I'll turn that down when I have the chance. I don't have the chance right now. Free pawn. Not a free pawn over there. I could have complicated this somewhat, and I didn't. All right, you take my knight, I take your knight. Oops, well that's no good. Alright, so we got a weird material imbalance. I'm just gonna call this weird and not acknowledge that I'm down buckets of material, and hopefully things will work out. Alright, next game. Nobody saw that game. Let's play this one and do better this time. Also, sorry about the whirring noise in the background. It's getting warm, so I need to turn on the AC. All right, let's sack mate. Two pawns, three pawns, maybe even more than three pawns. I'm not sure. Got that covered. Let's just develop. How nice it would be if this were Bug House. Oh, how nice this would be. But it's not. It's just chess. Okay, sure. I guess if I can sack, you can sack. But my sacks work. Take my pawn. I will force you to take my pawn, and then I will keep taking all of your stuff. Alright, so the threat on g6 is renewed thanks to this pin on the long diagonal. Hey! Oh, nice! Sounds like a party. I guess what else a person could want is to win this tournament. But considering that I'm kind of joining in 23 and a half hours late, although I did start earlier, but I'm rejoining in just a little bit late. I might not win the event. I know that's heartbreaking for my loyal viewers, but I can still have some fun here. So I'm hoping for knight takes h4. I completely missed that this bishop was covering h5, so it's good that he moved it, so I didn't waste a tempo playing h5. But yeah, I could just take here. Assuming he doesn't play bishop h5 now. If he does, I guess I just have to... Well, he's not going to play it now. I'm hitting his rook. I mean, he could play it now. I don't even want the rook. I want the king. Who needs rooks when... Yeah, you can take kings. Alright. Well, the good news is that if you enter really late, you get the easiest pairings ever. You get the people who have lost, like, 20 games in a row. Because you tend to get paired against people who've scored the same number. So there really isn't much to lose if you get paired... this late in the tournament. Oh, I don't want to take... Well, maybe I do. Okay, I'm stopping e5. Basically, my role in the tournament now is just to ruin everybody's hopes and dreams. As mine have already been ruined. Did I see... Oh. I didn't see that. I mean, I might have stopped in briefly once, maybe. I don't remember. But... Oh, here's an interesting statistic. So our tournament leader's got 950 tournament points. So, maybe he can score another 50 in the next 22 minutes. Maybe, but very unlikely. Okay. I want to deflect this rook, so it's not... Or this rook, so it's not protecting the pawn anymore. That was too easy. It's got to be some kind of trap. Although, no, I could just take and then knight b5. Okay. Well, this is definitely some kind of trap. Oh, there it is. I found it. At least got something for a pawn. Or for a bishop. Just keep pushing. Just keep pushing. Well, this is a bit disgusting. Oh, I didn't see that one. Okay, this is bad. If I didn't need a win, I'd offer a draw. Okay, so he's just piling up his rooks. in some kind of sensible fashion. And I'm trying to make some kind of complication here. Maybe I could even return the favor with the skewered bishops. Maybe not. Gotta go back. Easy peasy. Yeah, I just rejoined the tournament and now I'm in 199th place.
Red Lily's deck.
Really, when I've chosen to go berserk in these games, I do want to play super aggressively so as not to run low on time. It's a lot easier dictating where the attack is and where the front of the battle is than it is to try to defend against a vigorously attacking opponent. Well, that's a bit ugly. Damn. That's not where I wanted to put my pieces. It's definitely not what I intended. Maybe I should have taken g3. b4? Oh, he doesn't... Okay, he's not gonna fall for it. It being allowing me to trap his bishop with f4. Still, my pieces are kind of active. But yeah, I've got no time in which to construct a good plan. So I just have to keep moving, come up with some plan, even if it's not a good one. And just keep moving. That's really all there is to it. Hit my rook. Yep. I'm not going all in there. It could be fun, but it doesn't at all work. Similar to this plan, which also doesn't work. Alright, so I am not winning that. Let's play another game. A win there would have been 5 tournament points, and might have vaulted me even higher up in the event. But yeah, no, I've got a user script installed that hits the Go Berserk button every game, even before I see who my opponent is. So, doesn't matter. Is that a 2028? Yeah, it's 2028, not 2628. Queen c6 is not happening. Just develop. Okay, we got a pin. I think he just does knight takes knight, and I take his bishop. Okay, we'll make things a little more complicated here. So now this bishop is very thoroughly blunted. And my knight's kind of trapped, actually, so I might be forced to move it back and trade it. Let's protect this pawn. Now, I should have played Rook E1. There's my Rook E1. I was concerned about trying to get my knight to f5 and hold this while not allowing knight b4. Alright, so I hit this pawn. Obviously the knight moves. I was trying to get my... Oh. Okay, well, I guess not obviously. Alright, that's kind of a lucky shot. Right, so I just take the bishop. You take my rook, I take your rook, and I'm actually a little bit active here. Okay, I've stopped his pawn. Now, I have put a pawn on a light square. That doesn't work so well with my strategy of putting them all on dark squares. I might end up trading the bishop for the knight. I don't know. So I got my rook on the other side of this knight. Going to try to undermine it while simultaneously going for cheapos here. It's not so easy for him to support this knight, though. Actually, it might be trapped. Alright, my rook's defended. My rook is still defended. Again, my rook is not on pre. Okay. Maybe rook h5 is stronger. This actually gives him a useful tempo. Yeah, I shouldn't have done that. Now I'm forced to play bishop f1 when he checks me. Rook h5 would have allowed me to force a queen trade, because I think you'd have to play g6 and you'd trade queens. I guess rook c2 is a good pragmatic move. Just keeping the game moving and trying to either win or lose on the spot. Unfortunately for him, I found the mate in one, but perhaps I would have missed it. And if I missed it, I'm not sure how I'm defending against his shot. But I didn't. So this is like a Queen's Indian, except without a pawn. I've just given a pawn for pretty much nothing. Other than a little initiative, which is going to bubble out. Or fizzle out, or whatever the phrase is. It's ephemeral, is what I mean. Good old ephemerality. Okay, so my queen's attacked. Let's put it somewhere. Let's hit this bishop. No, I've got Knight Takes. Bishop c4 would be kind of nice. Oh, that doesn't mate. All right. Right. Yeah, I'll let this go. Actually, yeah, queen there was an excellent move, forcing me to trade queens. And I just didn't see that it was forced. Sorry. It's... I don't know, I'll turn it off for now, but it's gonna be really warm in here. There's not much I can do about it. Hopefully I can focus, okay. Let's get a Smith Mora.
Check.
Hey, we got an endgame, guys. That's all I ever wanted. It's just an endgame. Okay, let's trade here. I defend this, I defend this, just keep defending. Actually, I could consider trading. Which would maybe... Well, I don't want to take this pawn. It's too risky. Okay, we'll hit this. That would be bad. This looks terrible, but might be okay. Yeah, I'm not sure where my king's going. Maybe to g2. Oh, I just hung the pawn. Ish. I can't take there. Okay, we'll say that, that was for initiative. Yeah, no, I'm not winning this, actually. Let's just let that go. If I want to win some games this tournament, I've got to resign some games, too. You got to lose some games to win games. Yep, you did hear that. Well, you saw I played a Queens Indian-ish the other game, but yeah, I need to just play the French. That's going to cure all of my berserking woes. Just played king pawn to king 3. Alright, here we go. It's a French. Close enough. Close enough. Aw, man. Okay, we're gonna play this line. Gonna pretend that it's a French. Right? So, there it is. I played the right moves. Blame the opponent for not playing it. Okay, we're going to hang this temporarily and hope he doesn't see it. That worked. See? It's not so difficult to get some advantage when your opponent's not paying attention. Let's So let's just push, push, push. Knight e5? Yeah, okay, he plays it. I'll just casually go for mate. I do intend to play rook f8 at some point here. Which rook? I'm not sure. Okay. This forces me to defer rook f8 and just play my g3 threat immediately. Because I need this knight for the attack. Rook f2 would be nice. See, this is your typical e6, h6, g5 French. Cures all your problems. You got any positional or tactical problems, just play the French.
Check.
Take one of these. Lose a queen. You know, who Check. Needs it? Queens, they're overrated. Really, I got two rooks for a knight and a queen, so that's a fair trade, right? Pretty sure bishop e4 was a mouse slip.
Check.
But, you know, times like these call for desperate measures. And we gotta exploit that. Okay, queen moves, I take the a pawn. My key point is that I really want to play my rook to f1. He keeps denying me that possibility. So, I'll do what it takes to enable rook f1. So that's why I was obsessed with taking this a-pawn out of nowhere. If the knight moves, I have rook f3. Yeah, no, take my e-pawn here. That'd be a fantastic idea. Alright, can I convince him to take any of my other pawns, maybe? Lift any back rank threats. Still bear pressure on this here. Maybe.
Check.
Oh crap.
Check.
Well, I might not be winning this one after all. That's what I get for playing quickly. Oh, there goes my rook. He missed it. We'll go over here. All right. It's going to take some magic to win this.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, this is actually lost. I need to resign and get a new pairing. Can you pair me before the last minute starts? I mean, I'm not going to win any tournament points this way, but that game I was going to lose anyhow. So that's what happens with the French. It's refuted. Yeah. Although I guess it worked for Tatev, so. Yeah. Maybe I just need to play the French more often. Even though it's refuted, as we just saw. Alright, it looks like I'm not getting a new pairing. So I get to enjoy languishing in 199th place, assuming nobody wins a game in the next 30 seconds. Which is totally an invalid assumption. Somebody with, I don't know, 130 some points is going to win in the next half a minute, and I'm going to get bumped to 200 or so. I mean, you say tomato, I say tomato. Oh, look, I placed in the top 200. I got 199th place. All right, we're going to celebrate that. And how do we celebrate that? I'm going to make a tournament. And just so I don't forget, we're going to play the French. There we go. We'll see if this... Oh, that's a 2-minute bullet tournament. Yeah, that's not happening. Sorry. Yeah, let me create a good tournament. Let's make a 3 plus 2 lasting, I don't know, a half hour or so. We'll make it casual just so people can join in without being afraid. So, yeah. Here we are. The Pisich tournament? Weak points or holes in the opponent's position must be occupied by pieces, not pawns. Yeah. In case you hadn't noticed, the French makes weak points and holes in Black's position. Or at least weak points. Holes if he plays it wrong. So we got a minute till this starts. Yeah, I was hoping that Carissa was going to just get the Fisher Prize. How awesome would that be? All you could do today is just watch? Well, I guess I'll have to play then. I like how this is scheduled to start at 7:02 p.m. It's very official like that. Uh-oh. What's Nightbot complaining about?
Nine,
oh,
eight,
I see. Yeah.
Seven.
Now, I've got that same workaround in my local environment here.
2-1-0.
Yeah, no, for sure, I've got to deal with that. Oh. This isn't a French. Whatever, I'll play the French. I also have the Go Berserk plugin installed. I should probably... No. Whatever. It's for fun. We got a French. Oh, going berserk with a 2-second increment does not seem wise anymore. I should do something about that user script I have installed. Because, yeah, going berserk might not be very sound. So, we'll see how this goes. I might have some chance here. I'm going to have to pick up the pace, though, because I just played in a marathon where you had a lot more time than this per move to think about each move. No, take d5. Queen takes, and then we take f6. And then if he takes g6, then I win the queen.
Check.
But this might not be enough to win the game because of the dire time situation. It's pretty ridiculous, but that's just how it goes. But yeah, definitely I've got to disable that user script before playing additional rounds, because it might adversely affect my winning chances. Gotta take it. I mean, I just have to build some initiative somehow. I don't even care how.
Check. Check.
A little hard for him to defend the bishop. Thankfully, the knight covers e1.
Check.
So if knight e7, I take the bishop, else I probably take the knight.
Victory.
Alright, let's fix the user script before going on. Turning off Lichess Gone Berserk, because that just might not be sound to play with it. Yeah, you can try some workarounds to try to connect to Lichess. For whatever reason, it's difficult to get a hold of the IP address of the machine that is hosting the server. Oh, hey, look. I'm playing the French. Okay, I think this is a line. And then this. And I don't know. Maybe I take.
Check. Check.
I'm pretty sure I'm still in book, though. So this is loose. I think if he castles, though, I cannot take. If he plays a bishop move, I could take this. There's that, too. It's a bit concerning. Oh, crud. Yeah, no, this is actually gonna hurt.
Check.
I should slow down a little bit. But I can't help myself. Just have to keep moving.
Check.
And see what happens. But yeah, I should have stopped and thought about this variation before diving in. The marathon is still playing some influence on me. Yeah. I say that, I use those words because I don't play the winner often. I don't want to give people the impression that I know the winner. Like, I know it maybe 5 moves deep, maybe 6, maybe 7, depending on the line. It kind of requires a lot of knowledge to play, and I just don't have any of it. Or at least I don't recall the stuff that I've seen. I've seen a lot of Winnower stuff, but I just don't remember any of it. Remembering chess moves is just difficult. Okay, if he takes, I pin the queen. What else is there? Ah, oh, there's that.
Check.
Okay, I'm supposing that bishop d3 does get played. I should take here.
Check.
And what do I do? Tactics overall else here. So, normally I'd be thinking about rook c8. I think tactics dictate that I just can't do that here. Could play this rook to c8. And just move my center. This actually solidifies d4, so it's not entirely a wash. Oh, we're equal on material. When did that happen? Okay. Protect this and this. Or protect this pawn again and attack that. That doesn't quite work. So we'll go to this endgame, maybe? Okay. I'm still hitting this. I'm guessing knight d3.
Check.
This is a bit scary.
Check.
Oh, this is not good. Wait, no, I've got rook c1 check if he trades queens. Okay, so I defend the pawn and hit the rook. What's going on here? We're gonna bank it on this one. It's all based banking on that one move. But now I think I'm winning material. It's a fun little tactic if it does work. So if he takes my queen, yeah, I just take his rook, and that's mate. Ooh, he's withdrawn. That was exciting. Oh, Zvish's cheering for take the rook. Nice. Yeah, that incidentally worked pretty well for me. It's like I was saying, the French is a panacea for everything. You don't really need to study it, you just play it, and it all works out. No. No, but there's a lot I can learn, for sure. Sorry, I don't think there's a doctor in the channel, so I don't think there's a way to help provide medical help and such. Oh, poor Justin. Okay, so I see there are four people here. Okay, we got two withdrawn. I've already played Justin. I just won a game against Silas, who's withdrawn. And you would think that the logical next pairing, which I guess it's trying to avoid for whatever reason, would be I get to play against Jack. Yeah, here we are. Sup, Jack? There's e6. Alright. D5. Okay, we got an advanced variation. I think I'm supposed to play the knight here. Maybe the knight here to f5 and then queen b6. Well, this is an opening. I'm not sure if this is actually a main line, though. I kind of like my bishop. I'm going to keep control of this square, because I think I need that one. It's too bad I got two bishops and no knights. It really puts a stopper on this plan, but I'm going to play it anyway. Alright, g5. Oh. Well, apparently he wants to help me with this plan. Don't let me stop you. I was playing this g5, h6 stuff for comedic effect, but, if he's trading off his defenders, this might actually work. Alright, so I'm dropping the A pawn, but who needs it? All my pieces are in terrible locations, but ever onward marches Harry the H-Pawn. Yeah, let's push all the pawns. How could this possibly go wrong? See? We got a nice little pawn front. Let's see, this pawn's pinned to my king, so I need to defend my bishop this way. But now I crack through with either, well, one of these pawns pushed has to do something, right? Okay. So, I mean, he's only winning the queen. It's not that bad.
Check.
At least I think for a French, you're supposed to sack the queen or something. It's right in there with hand in your rifle without firing it. Okay. Well. Let's see, can I put my pieces on active squares and not hang them all?
Check.
Yeah, I think there's a bird out there.
Check.
Okay, just keep checking me. I'll see if I can get this pawn to f3.
Check.
Oh, right, he checks me and takes. Okay, fine. Now I'm just hanging my rook to a knight fork, which I have to walk into.
Check.
Like, if I try to avoid the fork, things get even worse. Namely, queen e3 mate.
Check.
Alright, just defend this. Nothing to see here. Alright, so we've achieved a typical French position. It's very theoretical.
Check.
I'm not sure what's going on. Okay, so he's trying to play Queen E1 mate. Probably succeeding. Yeah, I might be able to concede this one. Here, let's just put the rook there. Obviously, he sees the mate.
Check.
Oh, he's gonna play it anyway.
Check.
Well played. Oh, I installed a user style I made. It looks pretty cool. And then I added a user script. So check out the team user scripts on LeeChess, and you can keep up with stuff we're doing. Yeah. Well, with enough trial and error, anybody could do what I did. What I did was tons and tons of trial and error. Plus finding a user script somebody made to go color all the names. And I just kept doing a lot of trial and error with that script, too, to just make it look really nice. So now it colors, like, player names on multiple parts of the screen, colors the player names on the leaderboards.
Going berserk.
We're going berserk, guys. It's the way to go. It gives me the perfect excuse for if I lose the game. But no, it also lets me try to keep the lead, despite having lost to the guy who's now on a winning streak. It's the Hail Mary to try to win the tournament, despite having lost a game pretty badly. Alright, there's a pin. H6, I just take. Okay. If we pinned it once, we can pin it again. Let's see how many times I can exploit this pin for material gain. Actually, this doesn't gain material, it just exchanges material. So, the answer to the number of times I would use it for actual gain, so far, is just one. Now, if I get to play knight e4, maybe I am gaining material, but he's probably going to find some way to not lose material there. Likely, he's going to find h6 here and just try to ditch a pawn in the hopes of getting out of this. I was otherwise expecting b6 and just developing the bishop, or bishop d7. I guess knight e4 isn't obvious, because with like two pieces already attacking, the last thing you think about is, oh, maybe he'll attack it with a new piece.
Check.
Yeah, I've got to take like this. Now, if I could get my queen here, that would be cool. Can I get my queen there? I don't know. It's not so clear. I could also consider bishop d3 and just take here. If his queen's on the second rank, though... Well... Yeah, I guess if his queen made it to the second rank, that would be a defense against this. So I hit the pawn. Oh, actually, if he plays g5, I just take h6. This works pretty well, come to think about it. Okay, and he plays some move, and I play this. Yeah, you can also style the board. You can style anything on any web page using CSS, and it's pretty safe. Because it's just styling. It's not like you're writing some code, and that code could do malicious things. Generally, user styles tend to be pretty safe to run. Huh. I've got to look into why my page has a scroll bar on the right that offset the entire page dimensions. Something about my style must be messing that up.
Ready.
All right. Oh, we got Jack again. If he wins this, okay. He's going berserk. I wish we'd known we were doing the go berserk thing, because then I could have done it too. Wait, what? What's going on here? What line is this? Is this the A3 line of the advanced? Something's not right. So in solidarity, I was trying to play quickly, despite not getting any extra points for doing so. But no, I'm just dropping a pawn here. I did not play that right. Great. So, I'll just offer a queen exchange. Alright, he took it, and we get an endgame. And we see that generally I do pretty well at... Oh, wait, no, d4's defended. Everything's okay. I had a minor panic there, thinking I was just losing d4. I mean, I'm going to lose it eventually, let's be real. I'm kind of doomed to hang it, but... I played this because I don't want to hang d4. Now I've got to defend it this way. Okay, that was a nice pawn grab. That was pretty solid. I'm going to try pawn grab of my own. So I don't want to see this check. It's going to happen, but I want to at least delay it.
Check.
Okay, we're going to undermine the knight. And of course he's going to support it.
Check.
There we go.
Check. Check.
Can't go there because of the knight fork. Alright. Oh, hang on. Alright, so I defend my rook.
Check. Victory.
Alright, should I feel bad about that, maybe? I don't know, like, if he had gone berserk and given me a chance to also go berserk, I would have done so. Still, I kind of wish I'd known about it. Yeah, 1v1 might be more appropriate than a tournament format. Oh, we got mainline novelty playing. Yeah, let's just take a look at mainline's game. Black is going berserk, guys. Alright, so... this is actually just a mainline Rui. Bishop b3 discourages d5, which got played anyway. Oh, dear. Wait, no, d5's defended. What am I talking about? Yeah, no, white blew it. He missed his opportunity to take d5. And I'm not sure how theoretically sound that was. Maybe it doesn't matter. So, okay, we have an exchange. Currently material's even. Alright, and there you got the idea of knight c4 hitting b2, also hitting e5. But note, if the d2 bishop moves, white's able to generate some threats. So, I see. Maybe we do delay knight c4 a bit here. And gives us time for moves like bishop f5. Oh, or maybe we just trade bishop for knight. Sure?
Check.
this is getting dicey. This is not so accurate. Because, I mean, now that knight's got to move. Right? Yeah, the marshal, that's the word I was looking for. It's named the marshal because you can marshal up an attack. And it's actually named after a chess player named Marshall, but anyway. Yeah, it's 3-2. So there's a bit of an increment, unless you go berserk. Oh. Wait, that was a... Wait. I was not looking at the board. But, apparently materia is level, so there's nothing to freak out about. Yeah, no, that sack doesn't work. Nice try, but no. Yeah, we got king g7. And then, worst comes to worst, black just moves the rook on f8 and runs away. But I think he's safe here not doing that. Running away might be unnecessary. Oh. That's a bummer. Yeah, I think that just due to server issues, not necessarily Lee Chess's fault, but just due to server issues, there's been lack of popularity playing in some of these tournaments that happen after the marathon. I should probably just resort to using the lobby. But I'm curious about this game, so we'll get through this game and then... I don't know. Then maybe play something fun. Chess is fun, but trying to play accurate chess is kind of challenging. Alright, so bishop f5 is probably in the cards. Except for queen f6 check.
Check.
Sorry, he missed it. I was going to say sorry to mainline for tricking him, but white didn't even see it, so... pawn takes, and yeah, now black's fine. Except for one little detail. We'll see if he can come up with anything. I'm guessing bishop takes, rook
check.
Takes. Yep, and then probably rook g8 and queen g7. I don't know. Okay, rook f8's a good try. Intending knight d3. Except that doesn't quite work because that queen actually protects d3. Um, Yeah, there we go. That's how you get some initiative. And black wins on time. Well done. Oh, I know what I could do. I could take a look through some of the games I played recently. I did bookmark a few games on LeeChess that were recent. Obviously, you guys all saw that funny tactic at the end of this game. Oh, there was Zug Addict's game where he played pretty well against Spinal Tap, and actually, Spinal Tap just blundered. I mean, look at that final position. Bishop check, skewering king and rook. It was decisive. Why did I bookmark this one? There are a few of these I bookmarked. I don't remember exactly why. I think this one was just excellent endgame technique on my part, but I'm not sure. I bookmarked this one because I got mated in 33.
Check.
I needed an opportunity to look at it. And, oh, yeah, this one too. Black Merdemer. Why did I lose this one? Okay, so I was doing fine here. Or white was doing fine. Yeah, I was white here. Oh, right, no, during the tournament. Okay, but how did I manage to do so well here? It's not because the Black Merdemer is a super opening. And Queen takes f3 wasn't right. Apparently I should do rook takes and just start to pile up on the knight and possibly the pawn thereafter. So how's this line normally go? Rook takes, knight d7, queen d3. Go back. Yeah. So keep the queen out of this line because we need other pieces there. If you're going to have a battery, don't put the queen at the front of the battery because you're never going to sack the queen. I say that now, but sometimes you do sack it, but usually you don't. Let's see, what was this game? Oh yeah, this one. I was actually doing okay this game. What were my mistakes? Moves 20 and 30, and my blunder was move 22. So I actually did pretty well out of the opening. I didn't have the impression that I was doing okay, but apparently the computer thinks I'm doing better here. Until I play a4, just kind of in a panic, not finding an idea. I just somehow felt really anxious about this position. Yeah, this knight f4 is looming. Oh, we could have played that instead of queen g3. But this doesn't make black as nervous. Queen g3 makes black nervous. Although white... I mean, all his pieces are locked up on the queen side. It takes a long time for him to transfer to the king side, so... The fact that I've got, like, my pieces in the least active squares possible, it's okay. It's part of the tromp. And that's what happens when your opponent trades the bishop for knight. I actually played this okay, and I just succumbed to some weird attack. It's fine. G6 is questionable, but what's better? I don't know. Computer analysis doesn't say either, so that's kind of a pity. I could turn this on. I don't think it suggests anything, though, unless I play a move. Okay, I like bishop a6. See, I guess that's flexible. It leaves open the possibility of e6 or g6. I don't have to choose immediately. And I could even follow with rook c8 and just keep biding my time until I choose which pawn I'm going to move. So that's definitely more flexible than what I did. My other game... Let's see. It's a Scandinavian. Yeah, what's this? Oh. I got really confused this game. I played knight c3 before taking. Okay, yeah, that's no good. Okay, well apparently I was doing okay-ish after that. Like, I'm plus 4 here. I guess because it's hard for him to castle. If I just take b7, I'm hitting the bishop. I see he's got rook c8. Oh, here's the key point. So if he does take the time to play rook c8, I just play bishop takes c6. If he plays bishop takes, I take the queen, then take the bishop. Actually, if he takes my bishop, I still take on c6. So, yeah, I missed a shot here, which, I mean, exists mostly because of the marathon. And then, yeah, we got this. Oh, yeah, this is the part I was most interested in. So, let's see, where did this get... How did we get into this endgame? So I've got this really nice central control. He can't push his f-pawn because that would make this loose. And I just march my king forward. Eventually he's got to play a rook to d6 to start reducing my pressure. Did I misplay this? I wonder. No, this seems like the best practical chance. I do need to open things up for this to work. Still, rook e5 makes sense here, because then I have threatening rook takes h5. Maybe if rook ee5, rook d5, and... Yeah, actually that doesn't quite work. So my rook g5 is the best move here. He plays rook d5 anyway. Yeah, no, I actually played well. c4 makes sense. We trade. Rook g8 is a natural move. He doesn't have anything better, though, so that's a good for check idea. And I don't want to trade rooks here. So, apparently defending that's the best way to go. King f3 is not best. Oh, pray tell, what is best here? How could I do better? Is rook takes... Well, I guess rook takes is a better version of the game. Right? I should just take the pawn. Yeah, this is plus 0.4. And then he takes my pawn.
Check.
And I go forward. And this is a better version of the game because I have these checks and ideas hitting stuff over here. Assuming I can click on various squares. Yeah, part of the reason that the marathon was bad is because I just am not very good with this mouse either. So occasionally I would slip. But more frequently it would take me forever to make a move. So let's see. But rook g4 is the move that got played. Well, I'm sorry, I played king f3, inviting his rook in. And I offer a rook trade, which, I mean, he should have taken that, I think. I think if he trades rooks, he's okay here. Oh. Well, this is good to know. I mean, yeah, fine. He's playing something here. Oh, Zugzwang. I'm like, there's no way I can break through this. But no, Zugzwang is the key. And here, okay, c5. Well, let's take a minute to ponder c5. If he plays c5, what do I play? I think I have to play d takes, right? Because if I play b takes, we get that famous pawn breakthrough. And his king's within distance, within the square of the pawn, so I can't promote. But he gets the pawn breakthrough, and I don't. Wait, no, that's not true. B takes might be playable, but I think d takes is the way to go. Even though it makes double pawns. Maybe it doesn't matter. Let's see if b takes, then b5, cb5, ab5, ab5. Yeah, I'm fine either way. So, yeah, either pawn recapture after c5 is okay. Which one's more decisive? Probably d takes. Yeah. D takes is the easy way here. Oh. Not for the reason I expected, though. I expected that just b5 would put the most pressure on black. Apparently that's a difficult way to play this, and just winning the pawn outright. Having two doubled pawns is the faster way to win. I wonder why. So he goes there, I go king e5, king d7. Why would he go there, though? Why not play a5? Oh, because if he waits, then I play c6 and c5. So he has to play this right away, then I play a5. Oh, this is even better. So it takes him too many tempi, 1, 2, 3, 4, to track all this down. Meanwhile, I can take here 1, 2, and then race my pawn away, then I play a5. Oh, this is even better. So it takes him too many tempi, 1, 2, 3, 4, to track all this down. Meanwhile, I can take here 1, 2, and then race my pawn. And if he tries to push this pawn, he's just way too slow. And if he tries to push the pawn without the king's support, without the king going through this elaborate maneuver, the king is too distant from the pawn to support it. Pushing b5 is the simple way, but it's not the fastest way. Let's see, what are we looking at? Oh, yeah, that's the way to fix it. Yeah, both win easily. I was just curious, because I'm always curious about endgames. Like you saw me asking here earlier, whether taking h5 was best, and whether rook takes rook in the sideline, or in the main line, was okay. And rook takes rook. I'm just pushing all these positions to see how they go. Obviously b5's the easy way, but this is the most convincing way to do it. And white's perfectly fine and winning here. It's just good to know, to know as many positions as possible. Anyhow, so the game continued. He retreated his rook, rook g5 instead of trading. I checked him. He went back instead of going to the king's side, which I think makes sense. At least it's not bad. g4 is wrong. I just ran out of ideas here. Obviously objectively, this position should be drawn anyhow. But this gives black some advantage, because now he can play like h4. And it's difficult for me to break through. But we exchanged here. And then, to my complete and total surprise, he's playing for a win. After having exchanged the pawns, he's trying to activate his rook. Despite his pawns being fragmented, maybe he thinks I have the outside passed pawn or something, but that doesn't make sense here. Yeah, this position's extremely hard to hold.
Check.
And I check him and win his a-pawn. Note that if he plays king d6, c5, pawn takes mate. So he goes this way, and now he's just too distant from his pawns. But yeah, this is the best he could have done in the circumstances. Rook b1. No, obviously, if you see the game continuation, which is just b5, you don't play rook b1. You try to play... Check. Obviously, try to check the king, get the king away from the pawns. And once the king starts to walk toward the rook, then you start making threats on the pawns and try to draw this somehow. Yeah. I mean, okay, we could try... You're right that I could try out the b5 move here. That wasn't that position. It was over here. Wait, where was I looking at this? King f4... Yeah, here. We could try this against local computer analysis. I mean, you see the idea, I see the idea. You just keep the pawn here, and you mow down the h-pawn, and then you come back. Obviously, this pawn can't run on its own, because if it starts running, the king goes over and takes it. Oh. Hang on. Wait. Really? A takes. You sure about 8 takes? I mean, I guess if I push and he promotes and I promote, this is somehow not winning. I guess that's true. Yeah. But why not C takes? What's so wrong with this? Oh, because his king gets in front of my two, and I can't hunt down either of these two. So I have to play A takes, which is what I was originally intending, but
check.
It just seemed like a bit of a hassle. So yeah, we push. Okay, this is actually pretty straightforward. So instead of taking the h-pawn and pushing, we take the e-pawn, then take the c-pawn, then push the c-pawn with the king in the way. So yeah, that's the simplest way to go about it. It's definitely an approach, but I prefer this. Because then I just take the h-pawn, and then just run right away. This is way more complicated and needlessly complicated in the given situation. But it's good to know that this kind of thing works. Just in case I have some other position which could have transposed me into this. Either this or in a future game. Can I lower your auto insurance? Sell your car. Don't buy a car. Don't own a car. Don't have a car. Don't need car insurance. There you go. Car insurance lowered. Easy. Let's play a couple. Well, let's take a look at some openings and wrap up. So, find 4 strong moves. Castle. Castle. Castle's a strong move. And castle. And we're good. No, I kid. Bishop e3 looks strong. Knight a3 looks fine. Knight d2 looks okay. Queen c2. Castle again looks pretty strong. When in doubt, push pawns. This trainer really likes if you push some particular pawns, like h3. It says, yeah, that's. Or a3. Or a4. Or b4 or b3 or something. Alright, well, one of these moves has got to be okay, right? Bishop d2 is not good. Queen b3. Oh, this stops d5. Alright. So. Yeah, oh, bishop g5. I wonder. I wonder if bishop g5 is good. Let's take a look at this in the analysis view. So, oh no, feature's temporarily out of service. Try again soon. Bummer. Either that or I'm just not connecting to it right, but anyhow. Yeah, I don't know. Bishop g5, I think he just plays f6, and then, well, I like playing weird moves. So it makes it difficult for me to come up with theoretically sound moves. 4 strong moves. Well, there's bishop takes f1. This is a Benko, by the way. What else am I supposed to do in the Benko? Other than castling and taking an f1. I mean, I think this is an idea. I think this is an idea. Queen b6 is tempting, although it might be misplaced there. I really want to hit this pawn, but I don't know what's the best way to go about that. This doesn't look like positions I've seen, because usually I see bishop takes f1, king takes is the only way to take back. So... Yeah, no, I know. This trainer just tells you what moves Stockfish thinks are best. And it's not even the current version of Stockfish. It's some older version, so... Yeah. Oh, Queen c8. Now, I've seen Queen c8 here before. It's perfectly fine. Stockfish, or older version, didn't like that. But Queen b6, I've actually played a tournament game where my opponent did this. I just don't know if it's any good. It's mediocre. Maybe e6. Not e5. Not e5, that's for sure. Okay, we already tried castling. How else do I put pressure on this pawn? I mean, yeah, this... I should switch to something else. Maybe queen d7. I do not want to play e6, although I did try it. What else can I try here? I mean, we're really pushing the bounds of what's legal in this position. Queen a5 just gets the queen hit. I've already castled. I'm not really happy with this trainer. Well, yeah, how else does black increase pressure? There's got to be some tactics here that are okay. There's a nice update to Stockfish. If you could explain how that works. I do like the author of that change. I definitely like the author of that change, but I don't understand. I haven't looked at how the code works. But I've seen that author do other cool things. Alright, so knight fd7 is good. Maybe knight h5. I really don't like the moves this is coming up with. I'm going to try knight h5. Okay, I didn't like that. Also, I'm not sure how necessary that change is, or whether it improves the performance of the engine. If it causes the engine to find worse moves in most positions, then maybe I don't want it. Really depends what the nature of the change is. Yeah, actually maybe queen a5 is okay. But I don't want to play it. Maybe queen c7. Okay, maybe queen a5 anyway. Okay, we're going to leave openings there. I could flip through the openings button and just resign every position and see, like, what are key positions that are worth studying. Let's do some tactics. Alright, my queen's attacked. Could just take c1. That looks awfully tempting. If I take c1, knight takes d7. I promote, check, king moves. Queen d1, check. King e3. I'm sorry, I've got queen f1, just forking king and queen. And I'm up a rook versus a knight. Just not convincing in the eyes of this puzzle-solving system. It prefers that I find a better sort of thing. In general. Maybe this is an exception, but most puzzles expect you to find something far stronger. Actually, wait, now if I take, he takes my queen, I promote check, king takes, queen d1 check, king moves, queen takes knight. And I'm up an entire rook. And there's no checks. So I think that's the way to go here. Oh, okay, and I don't have to win the knight. Kind of a silly puzzle, but sure. Let's see. Oh, this is nice. Knight f4, forcing pawn takes, bishop h3, king h1, queen e1 mate. That looks nice. It's very visually appealing. In terms of actual puzzles that help you become a better chess player, it's a pretty dumb puzzle, so I'm voting it down. But it looks beautiful. But it's a horrible puzzle if for instructive purposes. Okay, is this queen trapped? I'm tempted to bishop takes g4, threatening the knight. I mean, it's pretty obvious. I don't know. If I take that, I'm not really generating any additional threats. Oh wait, no, my threat after that is bishop g5, if this knight is moved away. No, it's not, because I'm not pinning anything. Bishop g5, knight takes g5, rook takes g4. I've got a queen for a bishop and a rook, and I'm threatening the knight. Is there better? I don't know. Okay, bishop g4, queen g... Yeah. Right. No, that's... But he doesn't have to take g4, is the point. In puzzles, you generally want to find something really forcing. The problem with bishop takes g4, I think, is they just place king g2. And, okay, I've got kind of fun threats here, but nothing's cooking. Or maybe bishop takes g4, or maybe rook a1, threatening rook takes, and then rook here check, or queen f6. It's kind of complicated. Bishop takes g4 does win the pawn, though. And any sane person would be kind of happy just winning material. This puzzle trainer, though, really isn't that sane. And it wants you to find the ultimate best move in every position. So we've got to find something really strong. I think bishop g5 foots the bill. Yeah. So then he threatens a queen trade, and we pin the queen. And then we continue pinning the queen. And I guess I'm not winning any additional material, so I should just take it. Oh. I've got better. Really? Is you serious? Okay. Okay. Taking the queen looks pretty darn good to me. How can I improve upon taking it? It's not like I could just take the other rook or something. And queen f4 doesn't really improve my situation too much. I mean, playing queen f4, threatening queen f3, bishop e4 might be a thing. That seems a bit extreme. What else is my queen gonna do, though, right? I mean, I'd love to checkmate, but it's not so simple. Well, we're going to go for it. Okay, you're going to force me to find the fastest mate here. Fantastic. Really instructive. So, I guess... Ooh, this is messy. I was contemplating things like queen f3, then bishop e4... Rook takes e4, and I have nothing better than queen takes e4 on account of rook takes e4 trying to threaten a back rank mate, and he just plays rook a1 or queen b8. Forcing mate here is no easy task. I can't believe this puzzle hasn't given me the win already. Yeah, there's bishop e4 preventing, like, rook e8 check, I guess, or preventing rook e7. At the very worst, it does develop my bishop on this diagonal. Oh, okay. So the idea is bishop e4, intending trading queens and then queen f3, forcing rook takes e4. That puts me in a queen versus rook endgame. Problem with bishop e4 is he's got rook e7. Where I guess I have bishop d5, rook e8, king g7. I guess that does get the bishop to d5. Bishop on d5 is useful. Whereas if I play queen f3 straight away, he plays rook e7, and I can never get the bishop to e4. I'll try it. Nope, that fails. Okay. I'm gonna try again. I'm not very happy with this one. So I found this. Found this. Took here, which is pretty obvious. I found this. And I attempted bishop e4, which it didn't like. Maybe we take here? No. Maybe we queen f3. Okay. But now I can't play my bishop e4. Oh. And then I've got bishop h3. Bishop h3, rook 7e2. I mean, wait, no. What's going on here? How is this any better than the thing I found? I just don't understand. These puzzles are not meant to be understood by mere humans. These puzzles are for computers. So, I mean, yeah, bishop h3 is not the idea, because... Well, maybe it is. Maybe it is. In a really weird sort of way. Because bishop e3 forces rook 7e2. And then I play g4, right? So after bishop h3, rook 7e2, g4, he's in Zugzwang. And he's got to shed all his pawns, and I just promote. Or he dances back and forth with his rooks over here. But he can't challenge me with rook f1 or rook f2. Well, he's got rook f2, though. Rook f2 is definitely a possibility, because it's not like I'm putting my bishop on e4 then. So, okay, maybe it's not bishop h3. Wait, who made the last move here? Last move was pawn takes. So I could just play bishop e6. Oh, if only bishops moved that way, that would be so nice. Yeah, just play bishop e6, bishop d5, threatening mate. Maybe I have a simpler way after bishop e6, I don't know. But that works. Yeah. We'll try another one. Okay, this looks like a fantastic position for white. So, queen... I assume the pawns are going this way. Such a weird position, then who knows? All bets are off. But queen h7, king f8, queen h8, king e7, queen g7, king d6, queen f6. Wait, let's not get caught in the trap. King e7, queen g7, king d6, queen d7. And then we take a queen. So this is a really silly puzzle. Really silly. And the key point is that you don't just keep munching pawns. You win a queen. Excuse me while I go on tilt. No. Really? Really, really? I mean, I've got a protected passed pawn that's two squares away from promotion, and I'm winning a queen. And you have the gall to tell me that that's not the right answer? Okay, what's the right answer? It's queen c7 mate. Okay, fine. Whatever. I'm downvoting you. Not instructive. Anything but instructive. Alright, we're gonna get a good puzzle. And by good one, I mean something I can solve. Queen b4, we trade queens, and then I take the knight. Do I have better? This is... If I have better... Like, bishop b4, king d1, queen d4 check. Is mate, maybe? I don't know. Yeah, let's do this. And I guess I take the rook. I was assuming I take, and then queen b1 check, king here. And then I had something to follow. Maybe just take the bishop. Do I have a checkmate? I don't think so. Alright. Not a checkmate puzzle. I'm gonna upvote it just because it's not a checkmate puzzle. Yeah. So. I think on that note, we're gonna end the chess portion of this and load up another game. Alright, so for those who enjoyed the chess, thanks for stopping by. For those who enjoy good puzzles, good games, and such, stick around.